Mr. Heathcliff? I'm Lockwood, your new tenant, sir, at Thrushcross Grange. I do myself the honor of calling as soon as possible. I hope I've not inconvenienced you in my arrival.
I should not allow anyone to inconvenience me if I could hinder it. I do wonder why you should select the thick of a storm to ramble about in.
From thy bounty, through Christ our Lord.
I don't think it possible for me to get home without a guide. Perhaps you could spare one of your lads.
No, I could not. I don't keep accommodations for strangers.
I shall sleep in a chair.
A stranger is a stranger. If you wish to stay, you can share a bed with either Harriton or Joseph. Let this be a lesson for you, Mr. Lockwood. To not go on any more ramblings on the moors.
I can go with him as far as the park.
You'll go with him to hell.
Thank you. odd notion about this room.
The whole house is swarming with ghosts and goblins. If that little fiend would have got in, she would have strangled me, snatched my soul away. I'm not a fanciful man, ma'am, nor a dishonest one. I saw her with my own eyes, and felt her with my very own hands. Who was she? You have lived in this neighborhood a considerable time, have you not?
All my life, sir. First here and then at the Grange, when my mistress was married. The master retained me for his housekeeper until he passed away. Followed my second mistress here.
Indeed. Then you have seen a good many alterations.
Aye. And a lot of troubles, too.
You knew her?
2 years later, Mrs. Earnshaw died, without ever seeing Heathcliff as anything but her husband's ill-begotten bastard. I thought Inley would thrive no matter where he wandered. I never believed. I was the only one who truly cared for Inley until the night of his departure. It seemed I would be the only one who would regret his absence.
Why can't you always be a good lass?
Why can't you always be a good man, Father? Father?
Father!
Time for bed!
Nellie!
Time for your prayers, mister.
Heathcliff, forever, yeah.
Tell me, Heathcliff, where did you come from?
I don't remember. I don't remember anything before you.
I think you're a prince in disguise. Your father was the Emperor of China. And your mother was an Indian queen. And you were kidnapped by wicked sailors and brought to England. You're worried everything will change once Henry returns, aren't you?
Well, with Father dead, he does on the Heights. I won't have much to protect me but my own wits.
I shall protect you. My brother won't touch a single black hair on your head. No one dare try to take you away from me.
Nor you from me.
No possum in the world ever pictured heaven so beautifully as they did. And I could not help wishing we were all there safe together. After his schooling, Mr. Inley came home and set the neighbors gossiping right and left. He brought a wife with him.
Heathcliff.
What she was and where she was born?
The horses.
He never informed us. Probably, she had neither money nor name to recommend her, or he would scarcely have kept that union from his father. Young Earnshaw was altered considerably in the years of his absence.
Hello, Catherine. This is my wife, Frances.
Oh, isn't this charming?
This is my sister, Catherine. Oh. Our housekeeper, Nellie, and that was Joseph.
Welcome to Weather Nights, Mum. Kathy, Inley's told me so much about you. I've always wanted a sister of my very own, and now I have one. Oh, why don't you show me around?
From now on, Nellie, you and Joseph are to stay in the servants' quarters where you belong.
Of course, Maester.
And as for you, Heathcliff, no more curate and stay in the stables. My wife and I want the house to ourselves.
Inley became tyrannical. Vincent a dislike to Heathcliff. He drove him from their company to the servants, deprived him of education, and insisting that he should labor out of doors.
Horrible what Hindley's done to you. Things will get better. It'll be all right. You do trust me, don't you?
God.
Good. Well then, I'm going to read to you.
Heathcliff bore his degradation fairly well at first, because Kathy taught him what she learned and worked or played with him in the fields. They both promised fair to grow up as rude as savages. The young master being entirely negligent how they behaved and what they did, so they kept clear of him. It was one of their chief amusements to run away to the moors in the morning and remain there all day. They forgot everything the minute they were together again.
It's a sick revenge, but leave a place for divine retribution. Never pay back evil for evil. Let your aims be such as all men count honorable. Impossible. So fair as it lays with you, live at peace with all men.
What? Done already?
I think that's enough for today.
When Father was alive, we were permitted to play on Sunday.
I don't give a damn what Father did. This is my house now. I am master.
Henry, let them be. If they want to run around like savages, let them.
Fine, off with you then.
That evening, Inley, in a passion, told us to bolt the doors and swore nobody should let them in that night. The household went to bed, but I was determined to admit them in spite of the prohibition once they returned.
You could look. There's a light on at the Grange. I wonder how the Lintons pass their Sunday evenings. Standing around shivering in corners while the parents burn their eyes out by the fire.
Brushcross Grange, your new home, Mr. Lockwood, was once home to the Lintons, a proud family of landed gentry. Old Mr. Linton had long since passed, but he left two spirited children, Isabella and Edgar. They had all the Grange entirely to themselves. Shouldn't they have been happy? We should have thought ourselves in heaven. And now, guess what those good children were doing?
Livelier, Isabella. Livelier. Livelier.
Don't you wish you would have been adopted by the Lintons?
Looks like...
Livelier!
I am playing it lively. You sit down and play it then.
There's somebody out there.
I've never seen it.
Man!
You can lay her right there.
I sent one of my men to Dr. Kenneth. He'll be here within the hour. Miss,
where is it, sir?
Don't touch it, please. Please.
Sir. Miss, where is it?
Don't touch her, please. Please.
Sir. Get away. Sir, if you cannot behave civilized, I will have to ask you to leave.
We can watch her while we wait for the doctor.
But I can't leave Kathy.
Let me tend to her.
This little savage. There lighted a very dignified person.
Oh, Heathcliff, you may come forward and wish Miss Cathy welcome.
Heathcliff! Have you forgotten all about me?
Shake hands with her, Heathcliff. Surely that is permitted.
Heathcliff, what have you been doing with yourself?
I won't stand to be laughed at.
Oh, I didn't mean to laugh. I couldn't handle myself. Look how dirty you are.
You look lovely, Kat.
And on that note, let's go in, shall we?
May I present a toast to our guests, the Lintons, Edgar, Isabella? I bid you welcome to Wuthering Heights.
Why, thank you, Henley. Happy to be here. It's marvelous pears this year. Quite a yield.
Ellie. You make me decent.
My time, Heathcliff. You know, proud people often breed sad sorrows for themselves. I believe a few of Mr. Earnshaw's old clothes are in the attic. As soon as I can steal time, I'll help you. Edgar Linton will look like a doll compared to you.
What are you doing in here? This is a place for civilized ladies and gentlemen, not for dirty gypsies.
Wait! Till I take hold of those elegant locks of yours. See if I can't pull them out a little longer.
I think them long enough. Looks like a klutz mane.
Joseph will have to give my father's coat another brushing. Next time, Edgar, take the law to your fists. It will give you an appetite. Now then, who's up for a round of bridge?
for God to punish the wicked. We must learn to forgive.
On that morning, my first bonny little nursling and the last of the ancient Earnshaw stock was born.
How's the babe?
Nearly ready to run about, Nelly.
And Francis?
She'll be perfectly well. By this time next week.
But Dr. Kent...
Damn the doctor.
I'll go and see her.
Where's Kathy?
With Maester Linton.
I'm going to name him Head. Henley had an ancestor named Head. It's a good family name.
Aye, Mom.
Head and Henshaw. Promise me you'll look after him, Nelly. You'll love him like your own.
Oh, such a grand baron. The finest lad that ever breathed. But Frances, she'd been in consumption for many months. She had nothing to keep her.
On the other side. On the other side.
You going somewhere?
No.
What do you got that silly frock on for, then?
Edgar Linton spoke of calling this afternoon.
Edgar Linton.
Catherine and A were constant companions, still at his seasons of respite from labor.
That's 6 weeks in a row you've turned me out for that pitiful friend of yours again.
What you got there?
Oh, that's very foolish, as if I were to take notice. Where's the sense in that?
To show you that I take notice.
Here, look. Look here.
That is my secret.
But he ceased to express his fondness for her in words and recoiled with angry suspicion from her girlish caresses.
Every mark here is a mark that you have spent with Linton. These marks are days with me.
Must I always be sitting with you? You might be dumb for anything you say to amuse me.
As if conscious, there could be no gratification in lavishing such marks of affection on him.
Never knew that I talk too little or that you dislike my company, Kathy.
There's no company at all when people know nothing or say nothing. Hey, you're too drunk.
I'm his father. I'm not going to hurt him.
You're a drunkard and a waste child. A poor excuse for a father.
All right, Heathcliff. We can take a moment before you return to the stables. Just remember to brush him before you turn in. One more thing. Don't tell Maester Hendley. Nelly.
Your tongue has grown rather sharp of late, Nelly.
Get your hands off of me!
I never noticed what a woman you are.
Oh, not the time to take notice.
I could kill you. For speaking back to me.
Don't listen. I'd rather be shot every place.
Catherine, our time together has been, well, just lovely. And I feel we should spend more time together. I guess what I'm trying to say is, there's nothing that would make me happier than if you'd take my hand at marriage.
Are you alone, Nelly?
Yes, miss.
Will you keep a secret for me?
Is it worth keeping?
Today, Edgar Linton asked me to marry him, and I accepted him.
Do you love Mr. Edgar?
Of course I do. Who could help it?
Well, why do you love him?
Because he's handsome and pleasant to be with.
Bad.
Because he's young and cheerful.
Bad still.
Because he shall be rich. And I shall be the greatest woman in the neighborhood.
Oh, worst of all.
You're making jest of it.
I'm very far from making jest of it, Miss Kathy.
It doesn't matter what you say. I shall marry him.
Very well. Your brother will be pleased. You won't escape A disorderly couple is home in favor of a wealthy, respectable one. You love Edgar, and Edgar loves you. All will be smooth and easy. Where's your obstacle?
Here. In my heart. And in my soul. I'm convinced I'm doing wrong. Nelly, have you ever had bad dreams in the night?
Now then.
I dreamt I was in heaven once. And I was miserable there. And I broke my heart with weeping. And the angels were so angry that they thrust me out right into the heat. Right on top of Wuthering Heights. And I woke up sobbing for joy. Don't you see, Nelly? I have no more right to marry Edgar Linton than I have to be in heaven. And if Hindley had not brought Heathcliff so low, I would have never thought to marry Edgar. But to marry Heathcliff now would degrade me. So he shall never know how much I love. My great miseries in this world have been his. I've watched and done them all from the beginning. My great thought in living is his. My love for Edgar is like the foliage in the forest. Time will change it, as winter changes the trees. My love for Heathcliff. Like the eternal rocks beneath. Source of little visual pleasure, but vital. I am Heathcliff, Nelly. He is always, always in my mind. But not as a pleasure to myself, but as my own being.
Miss Cathy. Heathcliff might have been listening. He left when you said it would do you disgrace to marry him.
No! No!
Miss Cathy!
Heathcliff!
It was a very dark evening for summer. The storm came rattling over the heights in full fury. Catherine would not be persuaded into tranquility. She kept wandering to and fro, aimless of the growing thunder and the great drops that began to splash around her. She remained calling at intervals, and then listening, and then crying outright. She cried for Heathcliff all night, till she was greeted by the warmth of the rising sun.
Where the hell have you been?
Outside.
Were you with Heathcliff?
I never saw him.
He comes back, I'll throw him out.
Had enough of that gypsy dust.
You won't get your opportunity. He's gone. I lost him.
don't have to go. They have plenty of maids at the Grange to take care of Miss Kathy. I could stay here with you and Ayrton and
There's no use for you here. I want no women in this house.
But Ayrton, he needs a mother, sir.
He had a mother. She left him. She left me.
Frances loved you, sir. I'm sure it would break her heart to see you like this. The happiest man alive on the day he led Miss Kathy to Gimmerton Chapel. He offered me munificent wages, and so I had but one choice left, to do as I was ordered. And since then, Ayrton has been a stranger. Mortgaged every yard of land he owned for cash to supply his mania for gaming, drinking, becoming something less than a man, let alone a father. I got Miss Catherine and myself to Thrushcross Grange, and to my agreeable disappointment, she behaved infinitely better than I dared expect. She seemed almost overfond of Mr. Linton, and even to his sister she showed plenty of affection. I believe I may assert that they were really in possession of deep and growing happiness. But on a mellow evening in September, it ended. His cheeks were covered, his brows lowered. I remembered the eyes.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
A person from Gimmerton wishes to see you, ma'am.
What do they want?
I didn't question him.
Well, it's not one of Himley's creditors, is it?
No, someone a mistress doesn't expect.
Shall I continue?
Please.
I saw your face. Forgive me. I struggled only for you.
Edgar! Edgar! Heathcliff's come back!
to be glad without being absurd in front of the whole household. Ah, Mr. Heathcliff. Please, sit down. Mrs. Linton would have me give you a cordial reception. Of course, I am gratified with anything that pleases her.
As am I, especially when it is anything in which I have a part.
Thank you, Nellie. Well, tell us, where have you been the last few years? Abroad?
Yes.
Soldiering, perhaps?
Yes.
I shall think it a dream tomorrow, to have seen and touched and spoken to you. Yet, cruel Heathcliff, you don't deserve this welcome. To be absent and silent for 3 years and to never think of me.
A little more than you thought of me. I heard of your marriage.
Where are you staying? Kimmerton?
No. At Wuthering Heights.
Henley Earnshaw invited you to stay at Wuthering Heights?
No, it is I who have invited him to stay. It seems Henley mortgaged the property to pay for his gambling debts. I managed to help my brother with his finances. I am the owner of Wuthering Heights now.
Well, I'm here to see what you do with the place.
Oh, I wish you would have seen it when it was.
Kathy, do you think I could maybe speak to you?
Isabella, can you leave us?
We've both been through so much. But please. Please, we can undo what was done. And I have come back for you.
And where do you expect to take us, Ethan?
Well, away from here. Away from all this. I've seen the world now, Kathy. And it is beautiful. Come with me.
Heathcliff, I can't. I'm having Edgar's child.
How can you do this to me, Kathy?
How can I do that? Well, you'll find one to talk to. When you weren't there, you don't know. Don't talk to me anymore.
Kathy, please. Please.
Hey. You are to play nice to be with me if we are to continue our communications together. Get your hands out of your pocket.
Okay, then. It's all right. It's all right. There's still time. It doesn't matter. We can all leave. Me, you, and the child, we can all leave. Please, Kathy. Kathy. Kathy.
No, no, no.
You are my life. You are my life.
It's Kathy.
Stay with me, please.
I can't, okay?
Kathy.
Thank you.
Mr. Heathcliff.
Kathy was cruel to you yesterday. As a friend, I feel the need to apologize for her conduct.
You needn't apologize. I'm well aware of Kathy's nature.
Well, stop sighing and talking to her.
You are harsh and cruel to me.
It's jealousy that makes us strike out.
Jealousy?
Oh, yes. She is quite jealous.
You told me to ramble where I pleased while you sauntered on with Mr. Heathcliff. You wished me away because you knew I wanted to be with him. You desire no one to be loved but yourself.
Kathy can only put on a silk costume and play the part, but you, Miss Linton, are truly a lady.
Heathcliff is an untamed creature, and it is your deplorable ignorance of his character, Isabella, and nothing else, that makes you love him.
A beautiful lady.
Oh, Heathcliff! We've been quarreling like cats about you.
Catherine, no!
My dear sister swears that the love I have for Edgar is nothing that she entertains for you.
Oh, no, you don't! Go on, then!
Sweet Judas.
Who is Nanny?
You weren't telling the truth, were you?
Oh, forgive it, Heathcliff. I like her too well to let you seize and devour her.
And I like her too little to attempt it. Then again, she is her brother's heir, is she not?
No. Not much longer.
Wait, no, I... Heathcliff!
I told you to leave Isabella alone.
What's it to you? I have every right to kiss her if she chooses. You have no right to object. I am not your husband.
If you love Isabella, then you shall marry her. But tell me the truth, Euclid. Do you love her?
Thank you for telling me your sister's little secret. I swear I'll make the most of it.
Have you been listening at the door, Edgar?
I was not ignorant to your miserable, degraded character, Mr. Heathcliff. But foolishly, I acquiesced to my wife's desire to keep your acquaintance. Hereafter, you are no longer welcome in this household. I require your immediate departure. Nelly, fetch the men.
Kathy, this lamb of yours threatens like a bull. By God, Anton, I am mortally sorry. You are not worth the trouble of knocking down.
Heathcliff.
Wish you the joy of this milk-blooded coward, Kathy. And I compliment you.
Remain where you are. After today's events, do you intend on continuing your intimacies with Mr. Heathcliff?
Leave me alone. Your cold blood cannot be worked into a fever. Your veins are full of ice water.
Will you be with Heathcliff or will you be with me? You cannot be his friend and my wife. I require you to choose.
I require to be left alone.
Catherine.
I'm going to die, aren't I, Nelly?
You're not gonna die.
He be glad. He doesn't love me. He never miss me. I'm afraid of being alone.
You're not alone.
Oh, only feel the wind. It comes straight down off the moor. Oh, let me have just one breath.
I will not. No.
Why am I so changed? In an instant, I was converted into Miss Linton, the lady of Thrushcross Grange. I'm an exile. An outcast from my world. I wish I were outdoors. I wish I were a girl again. Savage and hardy. Laughing at miseries. Not maddening under them. I should be myself if I were among the heather. Nelly, let me feel the wind.
No, I will not let you get your death at home. No.
Look, there's my room with a candle in the window. Heathcliff is waiting for me. Heathcliff! I dare you now. Will you venture? I shall not rest until you are with me. I never will. He's considering. He'd rather I come to him.
Nelly, are you mad? Shut the window!
Edgar, you are one of those that is ever fond when least wanted.
Am I nothing to you anymore? You love that wretch Heathcliff.
What you touch at present, you may have. But my soul will be on that hilltop before you lay your hands on me again. All you had of me is gone.
Her mind wanders, sir. She's been talking nonsense all night.
Send for Dr. Kenneth. We must take precautions so she doesn't harm herself. Or the baby.
From Miss Isabella.
Hello.
What should we do?
She left of her own accord.
Who the hell are you?
I was Isabella Linton. We've met before, sir. I've just married Heathcliff and he brought me here.
Oh, Heathcliff married you.
From now on, she is my sister only by name. Not because I disown her. She has disowned me.
Where shall I sleep?
Heathcliff's bedroom is up the stairs, second door on the right. Make sure to bolt the door, Mrs. Heathcliff.
Why?
It's a great tempter to a desperate man, is it not? Every night I try to open his door. If once I find it unlocked, he's done for. When the time comes, all the angels in heaven will not save him.
I'll warn him.
I don't give a damn if you do. Wuthering Heights will be mine, his gold will be mine, and then his blood. Hell can have your soul.
Ellie, how are you this afternoon?
I've come to see Miss Isabella.
Have you a letter from...
I have nothing. My master sends his love, but he refuses to communicate with his household ever again. Sorry, Mom.
And how is Kathy?
Mrs. Linton gave birth to her little girl last night. She'll never be like she was. Her life was spared.
What will we call her?
Catherine. This young lady looks sadly worse for her change of condition. Someone's love falls far short in her case, obviously.
I should guess her own. Under delusion, she pictured me a hero of romance and expected unlimited indulgences from my chivalrous devotion. It was a marvelous effort on her part to discover that I did not love her. I've never in all my life met with such an abject thing as she. She even disgraces the name of Linton.
Take care now. He means to provoke Edgar past desperation. I'll die first. The single pleasure I can imagine is dying. Or to see him dead.
Not for the present! Out of my sight! Nelly! I must see
her. I cannot allow that. Kathy's delirious. She slips in and out of consciousness and remembers very little.
She must call for me. You know she has not forgotten me. For every thought she spends on Linton, she spends a thousand on me. Nelly, am I to fight my way through Edgar and all his footmen? You please be the friend you always have and let me see her.
you've broken my heart. And now you come to me as if you are the one to be pitied. I shall not pity you. You killed me. You tell me how many years do you plan on living after I'm gone?
Are you possessed with the devil? Speak to me in that manner while you are dying. Don't you know those words will be branded in my memory while you are at peace?
I shall not be at peace! I only wish to torment you. Come to me.
Why did you betray your own heart, Kathy? You've killed yourself. You. You love me. What right had you to leave me? The poor thanks you felt for it. Degradation and misery and death, nothing God or Satan could inflict, could part us. You of your own will did it. I have not broken your heart, Daddy. You have broken it. And in breaking it, you have broken mine.
I've often wrong. I'm dying for it. You love me too. You forgive me.
I love my mother, but yours, how can I?
Be your most diabolical deed.
What in God's name?
She's dead. I've not waited for you to learn that. Don't you snivel before me, damn you. She wants none of your tears.
She is at peace now.
Did she die like a saint?
You poor wretch.
Your pride can't blind God.
How did she die?
Her senses never returned after you left. She sunk into a sleep. Her life closed in a gentle dream. May she wake us kindly in the next world.
May she wake in torment.
I pray one prayer. I'll repeat it until my tongue is stiffened. Athanasia, you not rest as long as I am living. You say I kill you. Lord me then. Be with me always. Break any bond. Find me. Ah! Solely do not leave me in this abyss where I cannot find you. I cannot live without my life. I cannot live without my soul. I cannot live without my life. I cannot live without my soul. I cannot live without my life. Not.
Do you believe such people are happy in the other world, Miss Dean?
Retracing the course of Catherine Linton? I fear we have no right to believe she is. But we'll leave that to her and her maker. To the surprise of the whole parish, Catherine's burial was neither under the carved monument of the Lintons nor by the tombs of her relations outside. It was dug on a green slope, in a corner of the churchyard. But the wall was so low that the heath climbs over from the moors and buries it.
You and I have a great debt to settle with him. If neither of us were cowards, we could combine.
Heathcliff, he means to shoot
us! Are you as soft as your brother? Are you willing to endure to the last and not attempt repayment?
Enduring.
He will be my ruin and you and your child's death. Not unless we get him first!
No, you mustn't touch him!
The strength to strangle you, I'd go to hell with joy.
Isn't it enough you've already murdered his sister? Everybody knows she'd still be living if it weren't for you. So why don't you go lay over her grave like an old faithful dog? Surely the world isn't worth living in now, is it?
your brother abandoned you too. Clean him up.
Isabella, what has happened to you?
Finley is dead. He fought Heathcliff true to form, drunk as a lord, and Heathcliff fought back. I cannot live another day without villain. I'm leaving for London, and I've just come by to see you and the baby before I depart. If my brother asks, I permit you to tell him where I've gone. But do not tell Mr. Heathcliff. Will you promise?
I promise.
Give my love to my brother. I'll write to you.
Godspeed.
But with the handsome eyes of her mother.
Good morning, Papa.
Good morning, Catherine. Nellie.
Morning, sir. She had not been beyond the Grange.
If your father had any notion of you being at this house, you'd be glad enough to go out.
It's your father's, isn't it, Harrison?
No.
I thought you had been the only son. Are you a servant?
I'll see you damned before I be your servant.
You'll see me what?
Damned.
How dare you speak to me that way? Well, tell my father what you said.
Miss Catherine, you'll lose nothing by being civil. Although Ayrton is not your master's son. He's your cousin.
My cousin? Nelly, you must be mistaken. My father has just gone to fetch my cousin from London. A gentleman's son.
People can have many cousins of all sorts without being the worse for it. Miss Catherine?
Hey. Promise me you'll look after him, Nelly. You'll love him like your own.
Ayrton.
We'll not tell your father that you went to other nights.
I cannot understand why not. Before your father departed, did he or did he not tell you to mind me?
Well, since you deceived me in your counterfeit sickness, to break your father's one rule, perhaps you could repay me by not telling him I failed as your guardian?
I shan't whisper a word.
A letter announced the day of my master Edgar Linton's return.
Catherine.
Pa.
Now, Catherine, your cousin Linton is not as strong or as married as you are. He's just recently lost his mother.
Isabella was dead.
Just don't expect him to play and run about just yet.
And he wrote to bid me get mourning for his daughter.
Linton. This is your cousin Catherine. She's very fond of you already.
And arrange a room and other accommodations for his youthful nephew.
May I go to bed, Uncle?
A pale, delicate,
as
effeminate boy.
Nelly?
Good evening, Heathcliff. What business brings you here tonight?
I am here to see my son.
Master Linton has gone to bed along with the rest of the household. And unless you have something particular to say, you may entrust your message to me.
Who is it, Nelly?
I have come for my son.
He may be your son, but his mother desires him to remain in my care.
His mother is dead.
How did you come to know that?
How I know is of no matter. Surely, as a magistrate, you will not keep a father for caring for his only child.
Nelly will accompany Linton to Wuthering Heights in the morning. He has just come from a long journey and his health is very precarious. If you care for him at all, which, to much regret, I doubt you do, you'll let him sleep through the night.
Very well. I look forward to seeing you in the morning, Nelly. Good evening.
Mr. Linton commissioned me to take the boy home early. He was very reluctant to be roused from his bed at 5 o'clock. And astonished to be informed that he must prepare for further traveling. But I softened off the matter by stating that he was going to spend some time with his father, Mr. Heathcliff, who wished to see him very much.
It is truly worse than I expected. You are your mother's son. Do you know me?
No.
You've heard of me, I dare say.
No.
Your mother was wicked to leave you in ignorance of the sort of father you possessed.
I hope you'll be kind to your son, Heathcliff. He's the only kin in the world you'll ever know. Remember that.
I will be very kind to him, Nelly. You needn't fear. After all, my son is the prospective owner of Thrushcross Grange, and I should not wish him to die until I was certain of being his successor. That is the sole consideration in which I can endear the whelp.
Poor for a young Linton.
I cannot eat that.
The dainty chap says he cannot eat it.
His mother was just the same. Just as hard to please.
Don't mention his mother to me again. And get him something he can eat.
See, Nelly?
All is fine. Have a good afternoon.
On a beautiful spring day, my young lady asked to have a ramble on the moor with me. She was off like a young greyhound.
Young lady?
And as I toiled to follow,
you any notion of whose property?
She came upon Mr. Heathcliff.
I hope it's still my father's.
And who is your father?
Edgar Linton, owner of Thrushcross Grange. Do you know him?
Very well.
Miss Catherine? Miss Catherine! Is he your son?
No. But I do have one.
And you've met him before. My house is just over the hill. Perhaps you would like to come to tea.
You ought to come with me at once.
I will not. This man has just invited me to tea and says that I know his son. I'm sure he's mistaken, but what an adventure.
Heathcliff, my master, will hate me if he found out I allowed her to enter your house. I will be blamed for your devious design and discharged.
My design is as honest as possible.
I wish for the two cousins to fall in love and marry. And you needn't worry about your job at the Grange. There's always a position for you at Wuthering Heights.
Oh, it's lovely.
Now, do you know who that is?
Your son? Linton! It's Linton! Oh, you look very much changed. And you must be my uncle, then. Why don't you come and visit at the Grange with Linton? To think all these years, such close neighbors, and to never visit us.
I visited once or twice before you were born. But your father and I quarreled at one time in our lives.
Why did you quarrel?
He felt me too poor to marry your sister. And was grieved to learn that I had won her. His pride was hurt, and he had never forgiven it.
Linton and I have no share in your quarrel. If Papa will not let me come here, then Linton must come to the Grange.
The waffle miles will kill me. Please, come here, Miss Catherine. Not every morning, but once or twice a week.
Linton, have you nothing to show your cousin? Take her to the garden.
Oh, that sounds lovely.
Wouldn't you rather sit here?
If that's what you prefer.
I'll take you to the garden.
Very well. Behave like a gentleman, mind you. And take your hands out of your pocket. Now you've got a rival for your cousin's affections.
What does that name mean?
Some damnable writing. I can't read it.
I can read. I want to know why it's there.
He does not know his letters. Could you believe in the existence of such a colossal dunce?
Has anyone attempted to teach him? Or is he simple?
Please, there's nothing the matter but laziness, is there, Earnshaw? My cousin fancies you an idiot, Earnshaw.
If you weren't more a lass than a lad, I'd fell you this minute.
Nelly, you recollect me at this age. Did I ever look so stupid?
Worse. Because you were more sullen.
I would have loved the lad had he been someone else's, but I'm sure he is safe from her love. Henley would have been proud of his son, wouldn't he? Almost as proud as I am of mine.
Oh, Papa! I saw Linton the other day, at Wuthering Heights. I met my uncle, too. Why didn't you tell me that Linton was nearby?
Catherine, you know why I kept Linton's residence from you?
Is it because you dislike Mr. Heathcliff?
No, not because I dislike Mr. Heathcliff. It's because Mr. Heathcliff dislikes me. Catherine, you must listen to me. He is the most diabolical man, looking to wrong and ruin those he hates given the slightest opportunity. I knew that you could not keep acquaintance with Linton without coming into contact with Mr. Heathcliff.
But Mr. Heathcliff was very cordial, Papa. He didn't object to Linton and I seeing each other.
But I do object, Catherine. My reasons you would not understand. Your mother may still be alive if it were not for him. I will not see the last person I love in this world suffer at his hand. You were to stay away from Wuthering Heights.
Dearest Catherine, ever since I last looked onto your face, I have been able to think of little else. I would gladly think of nothing else. However, my memory cannot compare to your true form. I'm still not well enough to make the trek to the Grange.
Able to understand this world, to keep one's faith in its deep meaning, to reconcile the existence of God with the existence of evil.
How should you picture heaven?
You must find a way to defy Uncle Edgar and see me here, at the Heights.
How long have you been going to Wuthering Heights, Miss Catherine?
In a rustling green tree, with bright white clouds and birds of all sorts pouring music in at all sides. Only a little while. And it's only because Linton is too ill to travel here.
You should not be risking so much to simply visit with your cousin.
Nelly, I love him. How should you picture heaven?
This, warm by the fire, with you.
You've seen Linton but a handful of times in your life. He's the worst bit of sickly slip that ever struggled into his teens. And I'm glad you have no chance of having him for a husband.
I will see him again. If I had my father's permission, I'd spend half my time with you. After Papa, I love you better than anyone.
You love me better than him and all the world, if you were my wife.
What are you laughing at?
People often hate their wives.
You're false.
Your father hated his wife.
Could you say such a thing?
Your mother hated your father and loved his.
You liar! You cruel-hearted fiend! I'll not remain another moment in...
No! Catherine, please don't leave. You will come back, won't you?
Only if he's not here.
Your father's getting worse by the day. If he knew about your trysts, it probably would kill him. Stop this for his sake. If not for your own.
With all my love, Linton.
Oh, Linton, I'm so sorry it took me so long to get here. I had to read my father to sleep.
Good evening, Catherine. It has been so long since you graced my house with your presence.
My father is very ill.
The rumor goes he is on his deathbed. Is that an exaggeration?
I'm afraid not.
Well, perhaps I can console you with a gift. I give you what I have. It is hardly worth accepting, but all that I have to give you is my son.
What?
Father wants us to be married. He knows I'm glad he will not approve, but he's weary of my dying. Thus, we are to be married in the morning, and you can return to the Grange in the morning.
I'm not afraid of you. Give me the key.
Oh, you're not afraid of me. Your courage is well disguised.
I'm afraid now, because if I stay here, my father will be miserable. Please, let me go home. I promise to marry your son tomorrow if you let me go now.
I'll make sure you keep your promise. And you will not leave this house till I am your father. The only father that you will have in a few days.
At least send word to let my father know I'm safe.
His happiest days were over when yours began. He cursed the day you came into this world. I did, at least.
Heathcliff, you are a cruel man, but you're not a fiend. If father were to die before I returned, how could I bear to live with myself? I'm going to kneel here until you look at me. Please. Have you never loved anybody in all your life, Uncle? Never?
Get your fingers off of me. I detest you.
Everton, please, tell my father who I am. Please.
Father! Catherine. Where have you been?
Out on the moors. But I'm here now. I'm here.
I can go to her now.
I've come to fetch you home to Wuthering Heights now.
Father just died. Is there no end to your cruelty? Please.
I am seeking a tenant now for this house. And I want my children about me. I can give you till morning.
No. I'll go, Nelly. Linton is all I have to love in the world now. I know he has a terrible nature, but I know he loves me. And for that reason, I love him. Mr. Heathcliff, you have nobody to love you. And however miserable you make us, we will have the revenge of knowing that cruelty arises from your greater misery. Linton is dead.
How do you feel?
He's safe. And I'm free. I should feel glad, but you have left me so long to struggle against death alone. Now I feel and see only death.
Here is Linton's will. As you can see, he has bequeathed all that was his and all that had been yours to me. The Grange is mine.
Catherine stayed in bed a fortnight.
When Mr. Heathcliff was unsuccessful at finding a tenant for the Grange, I offered my services at Wuther Nights. Not even that would stir my mistress from her bed. And that brings us to now.
It is a remarkable tale. I shall never forget it.
I'll get some sleep, sir.
Quite all right. I must collect my thoughts. Ah, it is morning. We've talked all through the night. I'll be going back to the Grange now. I must rid myself of this awful place. Thank you, Miss Dean, for the accommodation and the insight.
I do wish there was more.
It's good to see you, Miss Catherine. Are you feeling any better?
I suppose.
I've found some of your mother's books. Would you like to read one to us?
I'm well aware that some people now begin to doubt about witchcraft, or at any rate, feign to do so.
Me. Get away from me! I despise you. I would have given my life for one kind word when you were my jailer, but you kept off.
I asked Mr. Heathcliff.
Be silent!
I would rather be anywhere than hear your detestable voice in my ear.
Continual strife.
Stay out of that room.
Strive.
He's just like the cart horse, isn't he, Nelly? He does his work, he eats his food, and sleeps eternally. Do you have a dream, Harrison? Harrison, can you hear me?
Go to the devil. And let me be.
I have found that I want and am glad to be your cousin.
I shall have nothing to do with you and your mucky pride and damn mocking tricks. I'll go to hell, body and soul, before I look sideways at you again.
You should be friends with your cousin.
Friends?
Mm-hmm.
When she hates me and thinks me not fit to wipe her boots.
It is not I who hates you. It is you who hates me. You hate me as much as Mr. Heathcliff does.
You're a damn liar. Why have I made him angry, then, by taking your part 100 times?
I didn't know you took my part. I was miserable and bitter at everyone, but now I thank you and ask you to forgive me.
Kelly. He wouldn't shake my hand and he wouldn't look. Nellie, since Harrington won't speak to me, will you tell him that if he takes this book, I'll teach him to read it. And if he refuses it, I'll go upstairs and never tease him again.
Harrington?
You'll be ashamed of me every day of your life, and more ashamed the more you know me.
So you won't be my friend?
Cured you of your laughing. It was me.
Mr. Heathcliff, might I plant a small flower garden on the north side of the house?
No.
She already has.
What is your grievance, Joseph?
An Ayrton. They pulled up three of my fine furs. She's bewitched the lad with bold eyes and forward ways.
Pull the flowers up.
How can you begrudge me a few yards of earth when you have taken all my land?
Your land, you insolent slut. You never had it.
And my money.
Enough.
And Harriton's land and money. If you strike me, Harriton will strike you, so you might as well sit down.
Against me.
You should avoid putting me into a passion. Take her out of my sight.
Why don't you eat, Papa?
Go.
My old enemies have not beaten me, and now is the precise time to revenge myself on their children. I could do it, and no one could hinder me. Where's the use? I have lost the sense of their destruction.
A cup of tea.
There is a strange change, Nelly. In every tree, in every cloud, filling the air at night and caught by glimpses in every object by day. I am surrounded by her image. Most ordinary faces mock me with resemblance. The entire world is a dreadful memorandum that she did exist and that I have lost. I cannot continue in this condition, Kathy. I have a single wish, and my entire being is yearning to attain it. I have yearned for so long and so unwaveringly that I'm
to you, I've made myself worse than the devil.
Heathcliff. Heathcliff? Joseph? Joseph!
Harriton!
I don't like being by myself in this grim house. I cannot help it. I should be glad when they leave it and shift over to the Grange.
Harriton and Catherine are going to the Grange, then?
Aye. As soon as they're married on New Year's Day. Since you're vacating the Grange, there's no use for you staying in this dreary house.
Who will live here, then?
Joseph will take care of the house. But the rest of it will be shut up.
For the use of such ghosts that choose to inhabit it.
Nay. I believe the dead are at last at peace. They are afraid of nothing. Together they would brave Satan and all his legions.
I wonder how anyone can imagine unquiet slumbers for the sleepers in that quiet earth.
Thank you.
Thank you.